Now, your questions now. Question one, Joanne from Berkhamsted wants to know, is there a way to stop silver from tarnishing?
Right, so silver tarnishes because it's been exposed to sulfur in the air, which reacts with the silver to create silver sulfide, which is a black colouring on the surface of the silver. Now, did you know that if you use silver polish, it will actually take off the silver sulfide?
A little layer of silver.
Exactly, it takes the silver as well.
So it's getting smaller all the time.
It is, but there's a way to take off your silver tarnish without polishing immediately and not lose any silver. And all you have to do is react it with aluminium. Now, aluminium is found in metal foil. So what we do is we put the silver in contact with the aluminium and it's going to reverse the chemical reaction because silver is more reactive... Sorry, aluminium is more reactive than silver.
Probably got enough in there, didn't it? Can you put it all in there? It's got to touch the foil.
So it's got to touch the foil, exactly. So it sets up a little electrical circuit between the silver and the aluminium. The aluminium is more reactive, so it steals away the sulfide part, leaving behind silver and creating aluminium sulfide.
Just like that, just in water?
No, we need to add some baking soda because it needs to be in an alkaline solution, so that makes it a bit alkaline. And ideally a little bit of salt, because that provides some ions to complete the electrical circuit. And then we just leave it in there for a couple of minutes.
I have to say, this is exciting, isn't it?
We should actually be able to smell it happening because the sulfide can get given off as a sort of eggy fumes
like
as well.
Bad eggs.
But in answer to the question about how you stop it from tarnishing, the best way is to keep it away from moisture. And if you put a piece of chalk in your silver drawer or in your jewellery box, that will actually absorb the moisture in the drawer keep it dry. And also, you should minimise contact with foodstuffs containing sulfur, like eggs, mayonnaise, onions, mustard, wool in your clothes.
Oh, yes, because eggs often turn silver spoon black, don't they?
That's why, because of the sulfur.
Question two, Bob from Ayrshire asks, given that a cloud is made of water vapour and an aeroplane has very hot engines, why doesn't an aeroplane make a hole in the cloud it goes?
That's such a clever question, because you'd think that the air around an aeroplane would be hot because of the engine. But actually, aeroplanes make the air get cold. Right. Now, the reason for that is to do with pressure, because an aeroplane's wing is shaped in such a way that the pressure above the wing is low, which is how the aeroplane flies. Mm. But when air is under low pressure, it expands, and that actually makes it get cold. And so the water vapour in the air around the aeroplane could actually condense to form a cloud rather than having the cloud go away. And I'll show you what I mean, because... Here we have good old-fashioned bicycle pump.
That's the most scientific questions with a bicycle pump, it seems to me.
In this bottle, there's a tiny bit of alcohol vapour, just surgical spirits, to just create lots of vapour in the air. Water is fine, but this just gives a stronger reaction. Right. Now, I've made a cork with a hole in, and I'm going to pop that in there. Really solid, so no air can get out. And I'm going to get you to pump gently about 5 times down on it. Now, the air is building up inside, the pressure is building up, and the particles are getting squashed together, so they're getting really hot, like when you pump a bicycle tyre. Now, if one more... Now, if I then release the pressure, maybe one more. OK, let's go. See, when I release the pressure, the particles all spread out very quickly, they expand very quickly, and that expansion makes them get really, really cold, cold enough to cause the vapour, the alcohol and water vapour in the air, to cause a cloud. And that's what could happen around an aeroplane.
Right.
But sometimes, if aeroplanes are going through a cloud that's already there, which is what this question was about, then actually it could cause the cloud to condense further, causing rain or even snow to fall, and you would get a hole in the cloud. It's called a hole-punch cloud. They're quite rare, but they do form. And so you do get a hole in the cloud, but because it gets cold, not because it gets hot.
How do you get all that knowledge in your head? So shall we see how silver's done,
just
to finish off?
Let's have a look. Oh, I forgot to say, it's important that the water is really hot, because with all chemical reactions, the hotter it is, the faster it will go. So this water is pretty much boiling, although I can
stick my fingers in. Remind us what we put in there. Kitchen foil in the bottom.
Silver foil, just have the silver in contact... Sorry, aluminium foil. Silver in contact with the aluminium foil. Bit of baking soda, bit of salt. Really hot water, as hot as you can stand. And look at that foil.
Would you look at that? Sparkling. Absolutely sparkling. Brilliant.
Look at these. That's some really silver.
Amazing. If you, I know we're very impressed.
I think it's so cool.
If you have a specific scientific question that you need answering, send it in to alan@itv.com. Tweet us at Titchmarsh Show or go to our Facebook page. A big thank you to Dr. Emily Grossman. Thank you. Come clean this over.